Hey, what's up everybody? Mike here with another questions for you, answering video thing, whatever you want to call it. Kind of mixed the words up there, made me look like an idiot. But anyway, gonna do two today. This is the only week I'm going to do two, just because you guys asked a lot of questions throughout the week. Just want to try to get, I'm not gonna get everybody's questions answered, but I'll try to get as many as I can. I'm gonna answer 15 instead of 10, so if I don't answer your question, I apologize. But I really appreciate you guys for asking the questions. It's very cool. Thank you. So the first question is, does your back hurt after shooting stop motions from Optimus Smith? Yes, it actually does. If you're, especially if you have to like lean over a lot, of course, and you're just, if you put yourself in awkward positions where you're constantly just bending over and having to stretch and all that crazy stuff, and yes, it does hurt after you shoot stop motions. Number two, where did the idea for Origins come from? I've always wanted to tell an origin story of Optimus Prime and Megatron, and that's pretty much what Origins is the where Prime and Megatron came from. Now, my idea for an origin story for Prime and Megatron isn't what you're seeing in my videos now. It's much different, and I don't think it would be accepted by the Transformer community, so that's why I changed it up and went with a traditional style that everybody can relate to, that everybody's familiar with. So, but ever since I've been a fan of Transformers, I've always wanted to tell the stories of where Prime came from and where Megatron came from. So, and that was from Matrix Bot. Number three, when you do stop motions, do you concentrate on action or story, or do you create a balance? From Cartman Tuttle. In my first series, I was more about the action because I was just, you know, going at random, flying by the seat of your pants type of thing. And it was really just an experiment to try it out, and then it worked, and people liked it, and then I created more of a story out of it. In Origins, it's more of a story. It's without a doubt. The action is there, but it's not the main focus. Origins is more about the characters and the story than my first series. So in a way, I am creating a balance from my first series to Origins. So, there you go. Number four, what's your favorite Marvel hero and villain? My favorite Marvel hero is probably Spider-Man and Venom. I just can't think of anybody else. Maybe the X-Men, maybe Wolverine. But I don't know. I think Spider-Man is my favorite Marvel hero, and Venom is my favorite villain. Venom is everybody's favorite, right? Yeah, whatever. Number five. Oh, by the way, number four's question was from Grimwolf100. Bleh. Number five. What is your favorite TF continuity? From SlasherCon. Without a doubt, Beast Wars. Love Beast Wars. Number six, what is your opinion on the character and environment design for War for Cybertron video game? From C2D904. I think it looks amazing. I love the designs. I love the way Cybertron looks. You know, we haven't had a game that takes place on Cybertron, so I'm really looking forward to this. I kind of get sick and tired of every time we have a Transformer series, it always takes place on Earth. We never really get to see what Cybertron looks like. And I really hope they go into depth with the design and Cybertron, and show like a lot of cities and the underground and all of that. And I like the design of the robots. They look like the War Within robots, which I dig. They look pretty cool, and the toys look pretty cool. So I'm really, really excited about this game that's coming out. Number eight, who are you rooting for in the Super Bowl? From Bone Crusher 4. Wow, I skipped from 6 to 8. Look at me, I know how to count. Well, we'll just go with 8 anyway and go back to 7. Who are you rooting for in the Super Bowl? From Bone Crusher 4. I'm rooting for the Colts. And I'm not saying I'm going to be upset if they lose because I kind of want the Saints to win as well because they've never been to the Super Bowl. But you can't go wrong with Peyton Manning. I mean, who doesn't like Peyton Manning? The guy is, he's classy. He's, you know, he's a really good football player, and I don't know. I could go either way, but I'm going to go with the Colts just because of Peyton Manning. So back to seven. What's your Beast Wars series about from Unknown Target 1, 2, 3? My Beast Wars series is about the combiners. If you remember the combiners from Beast Wars, they're toys. Well, they're toys that can obviously combine. One's Magnaboss and the other is Tripredicus, and they come to Earth. And I'm not going to tell you what it's about because it's really, it's just it's a high-paced action stop motion that really the plot is extremely simple, and so in the stories, it's basically just about action. That's all it is. And I don't want to give anything away, but it's just about the combiners coming to Earth and having a whole bunch of action going on and whatnot. So I really think you guys are gonna enjoy it. So Yahoo. So number nine now, Marvel or DC from Cybertron News. I think because of Batman, I'm going to go with DC. I can't talk today. I'm gonna go with DC just because of Batman. That's a pretty silly reason, but I love Batman. If you put any superhero up against Batman, I would take Batman any day. The Hulk versus Batman, Batman. So I know it's a silly reason, but that's how much I love Batman. He's an awesome superhero, or whatever you want to call him, comic book hero. Number 10, what made you make Orion and Sentinel go their separate ways in TF Origins from Stacy Alex 532? I'm just going along with what fans know from animated. In animated, they weren't friends, so I just decided to show why they're not friends. Give a reason why they hate each other. And I think the reason is in I think the reason in animated is kind of the same as the reason in mine. I think Sentinel was really jealous of Prime because he knew that Prime was better than him. So that's the reason why I gave or the reason I gave in my series is Sentinel became really jealous of Orion, and it just, when jealousy grows and grows and grows, and you just end up not liking somebody because of it. So, number 11, can you please do a stop motion tutorial from Robo Freak? 11. I'll try. I'm not big on doing those tutorials because they take a long time, and I'm in the midst of like shooting Beast Wars and Origins at the same time, so maybe after that sometime. I don't know. We'll see. Maybe. Number 12. Was Beast Wars the first series you got into from TF Freak 11 that I got into and followed and fell in love with the characters? Yes. The first series I saw was G1, but yes, Beast Wars was the first one I got into. Number 13, if you were a triple changer, what would you be from number one Canadian? Let's see here. A jet, obviously, some kind of flying machine. A jet and a pistol. Don't know. Trying to make it really hard, because jet to robot to pistol. Yeah. Make it really difficult. Almost impossible to happen. There you go. That's almost ridiculous. Actually, it is ridiculous, but anyway. Number 14, your least favorite character from SlasherCon. Rodimus Prime. I've said this a thousand times. Rodimus Prime. I can't stand the character. I never will like him. You cannot convince me to like him. I never will like him. I hate him. Stupid character. Pointless character. Utterly stupid. There you go. Number 15, when do auditions start for your next few series from the Swipe 95? I don't have auditions anymore. I'm going to start just asking people, you know, people I know. It's just simpler that way. Maybe for TF4, maybe down the line. It's a lot of work for me, and it's unfair to other people that don't get chosen. You know, and you guys are always trying your hardest, and it's just not fair for you guys. So, I'm just going to be asking friends, people I know, instead of having auditions. So, those are the questions. I'll see you guys. Well, I won't see you, but you'll hear me next Saturday for more questions. Keep asking. I'm not going to have two videos for questions next week. I'm going to have just gonna have one, and there's only going to be 10. So if you don't get your question asked, I am sorry. I apologize. Okay? This is what I call a filler for Block TV. So when Block TV resumes in August, we won't have these videos anymore. Thank goodness. But anyway, you guys have a good day, and I'll see you later. Or you'll see me later. Or hear me. Whatever. Bye-bye.